doing your own thing, and it's not for me. Grandma's porch. Sit down, relax, enjoy. Here on Grandma's porch. It's not for me. And doing your own thing. Hello, y'all. I'm Diana Brienne. Well, I have been behind the computer all day doing my schoolwork. And yesterday I was behind the computer for about 14 hours. Oh my gosh. As you all know, I'm a college student, a full-time college student at age 63, doing excellent in 4 out of my 5 classes, but actually I think I might be doing okay, pretty good in that one class that I was having problems with. But nonetheless, I have been behind the computer all day. And so I decided I needed to get out. I didn't go for my run today. I went yesterday, and normally I go every day, but I wanted to get my work done. So I went to my favorite antique store, and I didn't find any antiques, but I will show you what I did get. And I thought it was really, really, really cute. And so I'm gonna take you in here to Grandma's parlor. And let me put on the light here a little bit. And I just bought this little tiny chest. It's like a little, it's not antique or anything like that. It's more like just a decorator little chest, but it's really, really cute. And I think it opens up here. Let me see. Actually, I have to use both hands to open the side. Okay, it does it. Oh, there it goes. Okay, there it goes. And so it opens up there, as you can see. And I don't know where I'm going to put it yet, but I just put it here in Grandma's parlor. And so that got me out of the house. And so I was really rather excited to get out because, you know, I know everyone over at the antique store and I love to go over there and they're really, really super nice. And so anyhow, I just got back in and I'm gonna go back over to the computer and do all of my college work once again. And so it's been busy, but I wanted to talk a little bit today about doing your own thing. And it's not for me. You know, just because someone else does something doesn't mean that it's going to be right for you. Okay, it may be right for you, but it also may not be right for you. And for me, if something's not right for me, I just say it's not for me. You know, it doesn't make it bad. It might be perfectly wonderful for someone else, but it's just not for me. I also believe in doing my own thing. You know, right now I'm going to college, but I'm doing it my way. As I talked about in the video yesterday about how I'm kind of rearranging my life a little bit, and instead of making my college work number one priority, I'm making fun my number one priority. Rest, recharge, relax, and fun. And then comes school. And I know that sounds backwards, but that's just my own thing. That's the way I want to do it. And I'm doing my own thing, especially at the age of 63. And so I just really got to thinking about the importance of knowing yourself, knowing what works for you. And just because someone else is doing it a certain way does not necessarily mean it's the right way for you. You know, it may be the right way for you, but it also may not be the right way for you. And so the key to it is, do your own thing. And if something's not right for you, simply say, it's not right for me. It's, you know, might be right for you, but it's not right for me. So I thought I would share that with you today in between my exhausting, totally exhausting schoolwork, which I'm doing. I'm going back over to the computer over there, as you can see, and doing my mountain of college work. So I have to tell you that surprisingly last night, the class that I'm having all the problems with, which is not because I can't get what it is that it's teaching, it's because of the program they're using is very, well, let me just say, it's not my favorite program, and it's probably not most people's favorite program, and I'm not sure who wrote it and why they wrote it like that. But anyhow, I ended up, you know, it was just time and time again, I had to take this test, and I ended up getting a 95% on it, which I was like, yeah. And then I thought for a second, yeah, that's really great. But the problem with this class on that particular test, you have to get 100%. So I have to take it again. And it's a hard, hard test. So they require that we get 100%. And so I've got to take it again. I got a 95. Oh my gosh. All my other classes seem easy after that, but my classes are somewhat hard. They require a lot of time, but I'm really, really enjoying them, and it just takes a lot of time. But fun first for me, rest, recharge first for me, and then my schoolwork. So may God bless you. I hope to talk to you soon again. I hope you like, share, subscribe to all four of my channels, Grandma's Adventures with Diana Brianne Fairchild, Grandma's Porch with Diana Brianne Fairchild, Grandma's House with Diana Brianne Fairchild, and Diana Brianne Fairchild. My Diana Brianne Fairchild channel has over 3,400 videos now. So if I skip a day on here, just go back and watch some of my old ones. I think you'll enjoy them, especially the ones I originally made for family and friends like 10 years ago. So I think you'll enjoy them. So may God bless you. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.
To relax and a place to enjoy.